Hello friends, welcome to Fundo Tester. In last video, we had discussion about how to start with REST assured. So now we are moving into framework development. So first part, we need to create a Maven project for this. So we need to go to File, New, Maven Project. We need to select default workspace location. Next. So there will be different archetype of Maven, so we need to select org apache.maven.archetype and it will be quick start. So I'm starting, I have to give a group ID, so which is com, and package name is REST assured framework. Yes, we are going to develop a framework for the REST assured. So whenever we are going to finish, we can see here one Maven based or project type which is created. So now first thing is we need to update a Maven dependencies here. So in this project we are going to use a test ng. So let me read out of this JUnit dependency, and now we have to add one by one dependency here. So this is very important part we need to understand. First things what we are going to add, first thing which is a test ng. So we need to search in Google test ng Maven dependency. So whenever we are going to search, we can see here, so it will navigate us to Maven repository. So latest version is 7.1.0. so we can select this, just copy paste, and we need to paste in between the dependencies tab. Yeah, so this is my first dependency. Now we are going to start for a REST assured, so we need to add REST assured dependencies as well. So I have to search here REST assured, and we can see here there are multiple dependencies. So first is comes from io.REST assured, and another is .jw.REST assured. So here either you can go with the JW or either you can go with the io.REST assured, but what I recommended is to go with io.REST assured. So first thing is we should have REST assured dependencies. Yeah, so let me click here. So yeah, so latest version is 4.2.0. so we need to select what is a latest stable version. So this is stable version, so I can go ahead with this. So this will be my first dependency of REST assured. So we need this. After that we should have REST assured schema validator. So we can search here schema validator. Yeah, so this is JSON schema validator which is comes under io.REST assured. So we should have this. This is again the latest version of 4.2.0. so we have to add this dependencies as well. Now another dependency is required is JSON path. So we need to search here JSON path, and this is again we should have io.REST assured. So the latest version is 4.1.2. so I am adding this dependencies as well. So let me minimize this so we have better view. Yeah, so we add this dependencies. To format it, you can use control A to select all and control shift F, so it will be aligned properly. Now the another dependency is we are going to use JSON file in our framework, so we need to have Google JSON. Yeah, so we are going with this dependency, and the latest version is 2.8. so this is JSON 2.8.6 is the latest version. So we are going to add these dependencies. Now next dependency is we are going to use a extent report. So for extent report reporting purpose, we are going to use extent report. So for that also we need to add dependencies. So this is dependency, we need to add this dependency. So latest version is 4.1.1. let me add this. So as of now we have done with the dependencies. So to format it, we can add again control shift add and we can get rid out of this line with all the dependencies. Let me do a quick. Now to edit more detail, we can add developer name or who has created the project. So these details we can add here. So how to do? We have to start with the developer tab. Yeah, so this is developers. So I'm going to develop this. So this will be a developer tab. Developers. Under you can add multiple developers. So let's say you are working with four members. So you can have different tabs here for each developer. So like this, we have added dependencies. So similar way, we can add developer. So this is my developer. Yeah, so it will be like this. Under this, what is the name of the developer? So let's say name is Nishant. So this is my name, Nishant. Under this, we can have employee ID. So we can define employee ID, let's say for example 123, and then we can have organization name as well. So this is a standard practice. So we have to follow while we are creating the Maven project or anything, we are starting with the new things. Now we can add organization URL as well. So here you can give your official company URL or anything. fundutesters.com. After that URL, you can give a email ID of particular developer. So email ID will be fundutesters@gmail.com, and you can define the roles of particular developer. So this will be my role. So it will be like, there will be multiple roles. So again, inside the role, we need to define single role. If there are multiple roles, then we can define a multiple role. So role will be SDET. So again, Control Shift F, so it will get formatted. So now again, make it more comprehensive, you can add dependency version here, and you have to link them. So how we can do that? Inside the property tab, what we have to define, we have to give proper name. So let's say this is my testng dot version, and whatever the version I am using here, so let's say my version is 7.1.0, so I have to give version here. So this will be my testng version, and here how I have to define, I have to write like $ flower braces and whatever we have used here. So this is testng version, so I have to give this here. So this will understand why we need to write like this. So similar way, we need to give for all the dependencies. Rest assured dot version, and here we need to define the version in flower basis. We need to write exact text whatever we have written here. So you can write anything here. So I have given rest assured version, but you can give any name. Now here we need to understand one more thing. So I'll guarantee you no one has explained you this. So whenever I am going to search a dependency here, test, let's say I am going to search testng maven dependency. So it comes like this, and we can see here there are multiple tags: group ID, artifact ID, version, scope. Or there will be, if you are going to explore another dependency, there will be another tabs. So why and which tags are required? So main, these three tags are required: group ID, artifact ID, and version. So now what is a scope? The scope means, let's say whenever, so I'm getting this error because I have removed a JUnit dependency. So let me delete this. Now the scope is, it has defined here this test. So the thing is, I can use my testng dependency only in my test package. I cannot use in my Java package. Similar way here also, rest assured also, they have defined in test scope. So I can use only in test package. I cannot use in Java package. So we are going to use rest assured in both the package. So I am going to remove this. Even I am going to remove this as well. So if you can see another dependency, there is no scope. So only these two dependency add a scope. Okay, so now you can simply save it, so all the dependency will get download based on your internet speed. So if you can go to the Maven dependencies, yeah, so you can see all the dependency whatever we have added, we can see in Maven dependencies, inside the Maven dependency. So removing thing, I'll pause the video and I'll add here like whatever the remaining dependencies like this. So we have almost, we have created pom.xml file. From next video or next session, we are going to start with what are the utilities we are going to create. So based on that, we are going to create server packages and we are going to develop a server class. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching.